this line we are getting user input in a str variable, and the method name the get reverse the str. We are passing here str as argument, and this method will return us that is a reversed string into the str2 variable, and then we will display the reversed string. Let's see how does this method work. So because we have to return a string, so we have given here return type that is string, and then this is our string we have passed here. So at first we are taking here an empty string that does not contain anything, and variable name is reverse underscore str, and this is a for loop. We have initialized it from the string length minus 1, that is last index, because as we know length of the string is total length that is not counted from the zero. So for the last index we need to decrease by minus 1, decrease by 1, that is str dot length minus 1 I will be initialized. Then and this loop will continue until I's value is greater than and equals to 0, that is last index to the first index, and for each iteration we will decrease the value of I by 1. So we are concatenating here using plus operator, and because from here str dot caret method it returns a character that cannot be directly concatenate with the we cannot concatenate in the string. So before that we have to convert this character into the string. So we are concatenating here with the empty string, so that this complete thing will be considered as a string. So we can concatenate into reverse underscore str variable. So at the end we will get the reverse string, and then we will return from here, that will be received into str2 and will be displayed here. So we have checked here that is input, that is learning here, and its reverse string will be GNINRAEL. So we will see how to reverse a string in a second way. What is our second way? That is first we will code this code from here, and we will change in our code, and our program name will be something different. So we will give our program name that is reverse scale sequence string 2. Let me completely code and I will again explain you briefly.
Second way is to use the reverse method. In Java, we will take a string as a string buffer, and we will use the reverse method to reverse the string. Let's see the code. Then after that, I will explain.
Okay, that is perfect. So using string buffers reverse method, it is quite easy to reverse a string. you can see this is a object of Skinner class. Then print a statement to take the input, that is enter a string, and after that we are taking user input inside a string buffer as a constructor. As an argument we are taking here, that is sc.next, that is we are taking here our string as a input, and we are already passed here as an argument inside this, it's a constructor that will be converted into a string buffer. So direct this method string buffer object dot reverse method does not reverse anything, but it reverses the sequence of the character of string, and then we will printing here string buffer object. It is quite simple. Let's see third method. So entire code's structure will be the same. In a third way of reversing the string, what we are going to do, we will simple take a input as a string, and then from here, and we will pass a string object into the get reverse str method. This method will return the reverse string we will display here. So no need to change in this section. Now we have to work only in this section. So in this third way we are going to take this string as an array. Each character will be considered element of the character of array. We have to convert it into a string array, that is string array. We will split this string, whatever element of inside this string, that is a characters. So we are splitting this string, that is a by each character. So each character from this string will be considered as a string, and all characters as a string will be stored into this string array, that is str array. Now we will convert this str array into array list, that is we will pass here str array. So it will be converted into s.s list, that will convert it into list. So now this is a list, so we are going to reverse this list using collection.reverse method. So we passed this all thing inside its functions as argument. So this collection dot reverse method reversing this list. Now we have the reversed list. So now we need a reverse listing, so we have to join this list without any delimiter. So there is a method in a string class, that is a string dot join. So this is a separator part, so we are not getting any separator here, even single space, and we will pass, that is a str array, that is a list. So now here this list will be converted into this list of strings will be joined each other like a concatenation, and at last string will be returned from here. So let's see again. Now it is perfect. letting the reverse is equal to GNINREAEL. Okay, hey friend, let's see the reverse of the string into the Python also. Okay, perfect. So you can see from here I'm getting input as a string, and that is already passed into a get reverse str get star function. So this is a string, so at first we are converting this string to the list, so each character will be considered as a list objects of list, that is a list. And now reverse method of list is reversing the all elements of the list, but this method after reversing there is the list, so but we need a string, so we have to join all list elements into a single string. So this is a method join. We are joining this each elements of the list into a single string based on some delimiter. We use some delimiter to join the string based on some delimiter like comma or space, some anything, but we want a string, that is a one by one each element, like a string concatenation. So we do not take any element, it is a simple nothing. So this will be returned from here, that is a reverse string. So our input and output is perfect. Let's see another way. I will show you in a same code. It is very quick and easy using a list and we can just do this and minus one in a single line that will reverse the list. So in place of list.reverse method, we can also direct use the list and this colon minus one. That is, it means this list will be reversed in a single line and will be returned. It is will be returned a reversed list. So we can do in place of this, like lst is equals to lst colon minus one. So this line and this line will work as the same. So let's see, does it work properly or not? Okay, perfect. So I am just commenting here, so it will be remain here. And another way to to reverse a string using reverse method. Let's see how to reverse a string using reverse method. We will copy this code simply from here and use in next program. We will change here something for the next program. Program name will be the almost the same, just we will do here 2. That is the second program. Reverse the carry sequence of str2. So we will take a string from this function, and now a string is here. So we are reversing a string, that is s dot reverse or reversed. So this method, reverse method, returns a list elements. So this method will return a iterable object. That is, we will take some obj variable for that. So s dot reverse will be returned a reversed object. So to show in a string form, we need to join this object also. So we will pass here obj here, and in the same as last program, we are joining without any add element into this each element of this obj. So that will be completely considered as a string and will be returned from here, and will be displayed in a print function. Let's see how does it work. Our program is name is reverse care sequence of str2. Okay, here a reversed method always take a argument, so you need to do like this. You have to pass a string object here. Now let's execute again. Okay, now it is perfect. So no need to explain anything more. So this is our reversed program, reverse character sequence of a string. So hey friends, if you did not understand anything, let me know, write your comment in the comment box, so I will read and I will explain you again. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like and share with your friends and subscribe to Technical Learning Hub. Thank you.